Hey, what's happening, gamers? Welcome back to Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney, Apollo Justice Attorney. Ace Attorney Apollo Justice Trilogy. This is episode 52, and this is going to be the start of a brand new case, one that I've never done. So after the Maya trial with the priest from 2016, I never played the additional levels because I was busy doing other projects. I was busy doing Arkham Knight and Skylanders, Disney Infinity, and whatever else we were doing in 2016. So I never got around to playing more of the game on my off time. And I believe there were other games that came out around that time too that I just didn't bother with. So this next case is very famous. There's so many memes involved with it, especially involving that clown girl that you can see on the card there. It's called Turnabout Storyteller. At least I think it's a clown. This is a relatively not as long case as some of the other stuff. So you can see there's just some stuff here. So
yeah, Don says, so this is uncharted territory then.
Yes, this is uncharted territory. I don't know anything about it. I don't know anything about these characters. I know that I believe Athena and Apollo are involved, or Apollo is involved with the next one. And the next one, Turnabout Revolution, looks very long. Turnabout SP I've never done. The Turnabout Time Travel has Larry, Maya, Phoenix, and what's his face? Edgy. So I've never played any of these.
No. So it's called Turnabout what? Turnabout Storytelling.
I don't know why everyone was asking you about your back from, I don't know what happened though, so.
Okay, so I was doing Paper Mario and I was replying to somebody and I turned around, like from where I was sitting here, I just moved quick enough to go type and I leaned out and there was a loud pop and my back got hurt. And then in the morning, when I was helping clean up, because we thought we were having... Well, we didn't think we were having a mini-inspection. We just thought we can't really trust our landlord because they were coming in to replace filters or something today. They were only here for 30 seconds, so it doesn't matter. But Amber and I cleaned the house from top to bottom for 3 days. And when I was putting cardboard in the car, I didn't feel my back pain anymore. But again, I was focused on, oh my gosh, we need to clean the house. So I wasn't really paying attention to anything.
That makes sense.
That's where I stand. So.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, it was more than 7 hours later, though.
Yeah.
By the time I got up, I wasn't up all
night. Yep.
Thank you for the...
Turnabout Storyteller, episode 4.
Oh. Thank you for the super chat.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. What time is it? It's 9:10.
Shisho's dead. No, do you think he did it? Oh no, if he did it, then what do we do? Pull yourself together. Don't worry, I have an idea. Three suspects.
While enjoying a bowl of ramen.
What a way to go. Now I can't tell if that's blood or if that's ramen. Ugh.
Old man dies.
Sadness. May 13th, 9:45 a.m., District Court, Defendant Lobby, number 6. What the heck? Who brings a defendant to his own trial late? Plus, the request was so last minute, I didn't even have a chance to talk to with my client.
He's late for a very important date. Client?
Oh, it's Athena Sykes.
My name is Athena Sykes. Armed with analytical psychology and a full arsenal of legal know-how. I'm a fully competent defender of the Wright Anything Agency. Though I wish my client would show up already, the trial's about to start.
Heh, it appears we made it just in time. Where have you been? The trial's about to start, Simon!
Oh,
Simon? Huh, you needn't get so worked up, Athena. His baldness can wait.
There's no way he'd wait for me!
Wait, Simon's on trial now?
I don't know. And besides, why would I want to start off on the wrong foot with him right out of the gate?
Dealing with such matters is part of being a lawyer, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, well, covering for your lateness is not!
Lateness? Wait, he's a defense lawyer now? Still but a rank amateur, I see. I thought he was a prosecutor.
This is Simon Blackwell. He might not look it, but he's actually a prosecutor and a psychology specialist. He and I go way back. As for our shared specialization in psychology, we're both disciples of the same person, so to speak. But he's kind of my senior, I guess. But twisted sense of humor or no, I wish he'd stop treating me like a child all the time!
So, where are Wright Dono and Justice Dono?
Mr. Wright is abroad, and Apollo is helping Trucy with her magic show. Didn't I tell you?
They're what? So neither one of them are here, leaving you to take this on alone?
Yep.
Huh, ye gods. Call Wright Dono back. It's not too late.
Oh no, not too late at all. He would only need to know how to teleport.
Very well. Then I shall settle for Justice Dono. Go grab him and his horns and drag him here.
Apollo is literally in the middle of a show, Simon. You may not want to admit it, but I've got what it takes to take on this case. Just leave this to me and go watch from the gallery, all right?
As your defense derails in a spectacular fashion?
No! As I win the heck out of this trial! It'll be okay, promise. So wipe that look off your face already, will you? Anyway, I take it the guy behind you is...
Yeah, he's your... He's asleep again. Oi, Bucky, wake up! Ow, what did you do that for, Simy? Oh, gosh.
Oh, wow. A ramen delivery guy?
A drunk guy. Who's this yeller chickity? She's your lawyer. Such as it were, I'd say she's more green than yellow. Lawyer? She doesn't look it, does she? Is she like your fellow apprentice or something?
Well, he's falling asleep.
I can relate. Something like that. I've known her longer than I've known you. You could say we're bound to one another. Okay. Well, I don't know. Guess I better call her Miss Chickity then. Whoa!
Simon! This guy's not only rude, he's also three sheets to the wind at his own trial! I know we just met, but I'm about ready to give a piece of my mind!
Do as you will. Just save it for the end of after the trial.
this, chickadee?
Don't call me that!
How do you do? Slimy here's an old friend. Mine. I'm the fourth generation head chef of Wet Silver. Wheat Silver number four, Bucky Wheat. Nice to meet you.
Hey, it's nice to meet you too, Mr. Wet. Wet Noodle.
Oh.
So he can pull himself together when he wants to.
Huh?
If only the trial wasn't starting in a few minutes.
Huh. Having been accused of murder that only occurred yesterday, I'm afraid it's taken a toll on the poor boy.
As you happen to be there at the theater where it all happened, too, right, Simon? They said they found a Rakugo storyteller murdered in his dressing room.
Indeed. The victim is master storyteller Typhoon Tornado. He's a longtime patron of Wet Soda. Soba. Master Tornado had been looking after Bucky ever since Wet Noodle number 3 passed away.
I see. So the victim was kind of like a father to the defendant, huh?
That stupid old fart like a father? No way!
Oh my god!
He's always dissing my soba!
How dare you speak ill of him? Running your mouth like this is why they suspected you of murdering him in the first place, you idiot.
Wow.
Now pull yourself together. Number 3 must be rolling in his grave.
Oh, but Slimy, yuck. The police, none of them believes me. They don't listen to me.
It looks like he's still in shock from the whole ordeal. Don't worry, Mr. Wet Noodle. Everything's gonna be all right. I'm gonna defend you with everything I've got. You're in good hands.
You believe me, ma'am?
Maybe. Of course! No matter what, I'll believe in you to the very end.
Gee whiz, Miss Chickadee.
Now come on, I need you to shape up, just like those al dente noodles of yours, right?
Yes, ma'am. I so much the fresh... derp.
Oh, no. Mr. What?
Bucky, you're a great big pillock.
So, how exactly do you know this guy?
I used to frequent Wet Soba. Still do, in fact. So I've known him since he was a lad. That's why his father and Master Tornado were always so good to me.
I didn't know you liked soba noodles so much, Simon.
Don't expect one such as you who eats meat slapped between slabs of bread to understand the delicate taste and subtle textures imparted by buckwheat flour.
Hey, that's just rude!
But I digress.
I'm all about flavor and subtlety and stuff.
If I let Wet Soba end like this, I'll never be able to face number 3 or Master Tornado in the next life.
Oh, I see. And that's why you came to me, right, Simon? You wanted someone you can trust.
It was never my intention to ask you.
I'll show him. I'll show him I can handle it just fine.
Well, it's about time.
What? But we haven't even properly discussed the case yet.
What's the matter? You look nervous. Don't tell me you're chickadeeing out.
I'm just trembling with excitement of battle. That's all! Out gates! Let's do this! Come on, Mr. Wet. Let's go. Get up off the floor and we have a case to win.
Yeah, Miss Chickadee, I'm gonna do my best.
Wet soba.
Oh my gosh.
Hello? 2 bowls of noodles? Sorry, sir, can no do. Kinda busy at the courthouse. What? Hung up? Hello? Okay. Okay, let's do this.
he's not gonna do himself in, or this case any favors like this, Simon! Maybe we should let him go get some rest somewhere.
Let me rest? Maybe if I were a lump of regular flour dough or noodles. But I'm fresh like my soba. And you don't let soba dough rest. That's all about freshness. Get out of the buckwheat seeds fresh to cut dog ball.
He's explaining how to make the noodles. Oh,
my He's blacked out.
Oh boy, I just knew something like this would happen. Simon, what are these three brushes of soba he was talking about?
First, buckwheat seeds, or groats.
Yeah, I think so, groats.
Are ground to make buckwheat flour. Then, the dough made with this flour is cut with large rectangular knife into noodles. And finally, the buckwheat noodles are boiled. Each step is done in immediately, one after the other, so that the soba is fresh when eaten.
Oh, so that's what he meant. I see. I wouldn't want him to make me any soba right now, though. That's for sure.
Athena, this is no time for idle chit-chat. You need to get into the courtroom now. Just remember, as a prosecutor, I will be unable to lend you a hand. So don't expect any help from my quarter.
There you go, treating me like I'm an incompetent again! For your information, Simon, I wasn't planning on asking you for help anyway. Ugh, just you wait, Simon. I'll show you.
So how long has it been after Dual Destinies?
I don't know. Mr. Wright and Apollo may not even be here, but that's all right. I can do this on my own!
Here we go.
May 13th, 9:50 a.m. District Court, courtroom number 4.
Court begins. New client. Okay. Oh, whoops.
Oh, it's Japifornia's favorite noodles. Okay. California/Japan. Yeah.
Arise for the honorable me. It's time that we begin this farce. It's time we begin court.
It's a trial, Your Honor.
Court is now in session for the trial of Bucky Wheat.
Wow. Yeah, it could be Bucky Wheat, yeah. The defense is ready, Your Honor!
The prosecution is fully prepared, Your Honor. Wait, how am I here? I was just getting my butt kicked by Phoenix Wright.
I thought you lived in a different country.
What's this? No prayer this time, Prosecutor Sadman?
That is correct, Your Honor. To expedite these proceedings, I completed them beforehand in the lobby.
Very thoughtful of you. Oh.
Brandon says, just so you know, that boy is drunk. Thank you, Brandon. I appreciate that.
I could tell by his mannerisms.
He was all like kind of like swooning all over the place.
He's hitting that hard soba.
By the way, what brings you back to this country? I thought you were gone.
Chief Prosecutor Edgeworth himself called on me to handle this case. Besides, I have a debt to repay. And though my opponent is yet a callow thing, I have no qualms with sending her down to hell.
Objection!
Objection! If you have a score to settle, it's with Apollo, not me. But more importantly, I am not a callow thing. I am qualified and a capable attorney.
Then what is that yellow attire, if not proof of your immaturity, you small spring chick? Now, cease your shrill chirping.
Now, prosecutor, don't be a sore loser. She's still only a teenager. Please go easy on her.
Great. Now even the judge is giving me the kid treatment.
You are only 18 years old, I believe, or 17.
Very well. Shall we begin, Your Honor?
Yes, I suppose we should. Now then, prosecutor, please give your opening statement if you could.
I'll show them what I can do. They'll be sorry they underestimated me.
Yes, yes, all right.
You'll be sorry, Judge!
Certainly. Let the last rites of the victim commence.
Yeah, he got here from the power of Corneria. That's right, Crossfighter. Do a barrel roll!
He's summoning Arwing.
Yeah, I can't remember how to do the cross. Darn it! Star Fox.
It starts with da 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 da, and then it repeats and it goes dun 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 dun
dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun.
This incident is believed to have occurred at around 4 p.m. yesterday, May 12th, at Storyteller's Theater called, Kurukurute. The victim was a great master of the tornado school of Rakugo, comedic storytelling. His name was, Tofu Tornado. Typhoon Tornado, whatever. The scene of the murder was the theater's dressing room. It is accessible via the staff entrance hallway and has an inner and outer sliding door.
That is one large scroll, says Macho.
Hi, hi.
How did I get here? Crossfighter says, Nayuta. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor. Wait, how did I even get here?
That's not to worry about it.
The estimated time of death is between 2 p.m. and 5 p.m. The cause of death is suffocation, though how the victim suffocated is yet to be determined. The autopsy found nothing unusual in his lungs or stomach, and there's no murder weapon.
Oh, he didn't get to finish his bowl of ramen.
Could he had a heart attack in his soup?
I will allow you now to submit the incident report to the court record.
Thing added to the court record.
If it didn't make sense for copyright and nobody cared, I would have played Star Fox music the entire time we were in Corneria last time. That would have been fun.
There's a big case after that that's in Corneria. This is a smaller case.
Oh, okay.
But this is a meme case.
Oh, yeah, and we already saw the clown on the picture on the beginning of this, so... I may put the clown on the thumbnail tomorrow. It's not necessarily a spoiler that there's a clown person in this because we saw there was a clown person. I don't know who they are, but... Prosecutor Sadmati, how can you name Mr. Wet as the culprit when you don't even know how the victim was killed or even with what?
While it is true that the weapon and precise method are as yet unknown... The accused is the only one who had the opportunity to commit the murder. I will explain this assertion in further detail as we continue.
Ah! I guess that means he has some kind of evidence to present!
I would eat on your own time. Now, would the accused care to plead his case? Oh dear.
Come to think of it, where is the defendant, Miss Sykes?
He fell on the ground, I think. Sorry, Your Honor, but I'm afraid Mr. Wet, he's not feeling very well. He's kind of resting in the infirmary.
Surely it is the lack of clear conscience that impedes him from facing this court.
Great. Starting off on the wrong foot already.
Mr. Wet is the chef head of soba shop frequented by the victim. On the day of the incident, Mr. Wet went to the theater at the victim's request. Mr. Tornado was a connoisseur of soba, as you can see in this photograph. He was apparently making soba himself in his dressing room that very day. The soba found at the scene is likely the soba he himself made there.
Liking soba is one thing, but making it inside a theater dressing room is a bit much, no?
I suppose.
Master Tornado truly had a passion for soba, didn't he? For a man like that to be murdered by a soba chef is simply unthinkable.
And yet, the accused had ample motive, Your Honor. For in the victim's safe, we discovered the deed to the accused shop. Mr. Wet was to inherit the Wet Soba when he lost his father recently. However, it is believed the victims stole the shop's deed during the transfer process. The prosecution believes the accused killed the victim in order to get the deed back.
Okay.
What deed added to the court record?
A murder over the deed to a shop. That does sound like a plausible motive.
So that's what this case is about. I wish Simon had filled me in a little better. I could have contributed more than just 1,000 buckets of cold sweat if he had.
Defense. From your demeanor, I gather you know very little about the details of this case.
Well, you see...
Silence. You are dishonoring the soul of the victim by appearing in the courtroom unprepared. You are an embarrassment to your profession, you putrid egg yolk.
Ah! I'm sorry! Apollo's a red pepper, and now I'm an egg yolk? We've only just started, and I've already been demoted from spring chick!
I'm ready to call my first witness, Your Honor. It's a butterfly. Let us listen to the words of the one who was present when the crime was discovered.
Someone who was there when the victim's body was found.
All right, very well. Witness, please take the stand. Nah.
Simon Black.
Great.
Oh, give me a minute.
Wait, did she know that Simon was a witness?
I don't know. What is the name of this? The Storyteller? What is this called again? Oh. Turnabout. I got it.
So the guy who's actually being accused is the head chef. That's interesting because he doesn't look very old. But, I mean, you can be a head chef if you work extremely hard, I guess.
Okay, here we go.
She did not, Amber, says Everly. Okay, thank you, Everly.
Witness, please state your name and occupation. Simon Blackwell, prosecutor.
Prosecutor Blackwell!
What?
You did not tell me you were going to take the stand today!
Must have slipped my mind. There simply wasn't time. Oh. What a shame, Prosecutor Blackwell. Had you shared the damning scene you witnessed beforehand with the defense, we could have moved this trial along and saved the victim's soul that much faster.
Darning scene! Darn it! What in the world did Simon see?
Prosecutor, what is it? Before I give my testimony, there's something I'd like to confirm. By all means. This case involves rakugo, a very traditional form of Japanese comedic storytelling. Do you have enough knowledge of this art form to handle the case competently? Are you implying that I'm not qualified for this case? Not yet. I'm simply trying to ascertain your familiarity with the topic, for now. It is the prosecutor's duty to learn the background of any case he takes on. I did some research on rakugo last night, and I have grasped the overall idea for it. How much could you possibly grasp in a single night? Rakugo is a form of entertaining storytelling that originated in the land of Japan. It is the storytelling sits alone on the stage with only a fan and a towel and the rakugo artist tells long whimsical stories giving each character a distinct voice. This tradition art was originally invented by monks to make sermons more interesting. Are you satisfied? If not, I could explain the 12 types of endings to such stories. Or shall I perform the famous story of... Jigamoo instead? Let's get Jigamoo. It appears you have put in a bit of study. Your acknowledgement is most welcome, Prosecutor.
I can see why you're known as being quite the thorough in your research, Prosecutor. Now then, we'd love to see you perform that story you mentioned, if you don't mind.
If that is your Honor's request.
Hold it! Your Honor! Could we please get back to the trial now?
Oh, all right, I suppose, of course. I nearly forgot, though I was curious to see him perform.
Seriously? Of all the things that you would forget?
Now then, back to the case at hand, because egg yolk there is a party pooper.
What?
Prosecutor Blackwell, please tell this court what you witnessed. Thank you.
Egg yolk.
That's right. Egg yolk, chickadee, whatever. What Simon saw.
I'm neither of those!
I went to the theater yesterday and arrived at approximately 4 p.m. I went straight to the master's dressing room to say hello. Bucky went into the dressing room after, only to come storming out a while later. Master Torpedo's junior disciple, Uendo, apparently then entered the room after. That's when they discovered the master's body.
I have no idea how to say their name.
I think Uendo. Yeah, Uendo. Sounds good, but it's difficult to say because it's two vowels. Now, just wait a minute here, Prosecutor Blackwell.
All right, guys. We are 30 minutes into the stream and almost at 100 likes. Keep going with the likes if you haven't already. Thank you very much. Okay, let's go. Amber Redderline. Did you read
that? Wait a minute here, Prosecutor Blackwell.
Oh, okay, yeah.
With testimony like that, you're practically accusing Mr. Wett of the crime.
All I can do is state what I saw. I can't help how it appears. But a qualified and capable attorney such as you should be able to dispatch with it, right?
Well, yeah. Duh! All right. Guess I'd better start by getting all the info out of him that I can.
Okay, one second.
He's very tired.
It's been a long... something. What he saw. What Simon... I can't even spell Simon. Simon saw... Okay, what Simon saw.
I went to the theater yesterday and arrived at approximately 4 p.m.
Hold it! Prosecutor Blackwell, what did you go to the theater for in the first place?
What? I went because I had received an invitation from Master Tornado. Here, see for yourself.
Oh.
It was quite a special show commemorating his junior disciple's performance. It was also an occasion to announce the boy's succession to the stage name, Uendo 2.
I guess that's the name.
Oh, yeah, Uendo 2.
Uendo 2 works, there you go.
So, what exactly does it mean to succeed to a stage name, huh?
You really don't know, do you? In performing arts, a name succession is when an artist inherits a predecessor's name.
Oh, I see. So there was another Uendo Rakugo artist before, and this disciple succeeded him, huh? And what exactly did your invitation say?
It contained a simple letter of salutations and an outline of the show's program.
Oh, yes, it appears that Mr. Tornado was going to perform Toki Soba, or Time Soba. He's famous for his masterful pantomime of the eating soba using only his fan as a prop. And Uendo was to perform Sobe Say, or Soba Glutton, a Sobe-themed show, I see.
It seems you know a thing or two about Rakugo yourself, your baldness. First to perform was the senior disciple,
followed by Uendo, and lastly, Master Tornado.
At least I think his name is Master Tornado.
Invitation has been added to the court record. I see. So that's why you happened to be at the Storyteller's Theater yesterday. So what happened after you arrived?
I ate food. Probably.
Oh, we made 100 likes. Hooray.
Why am I sharing the wrong... I'm sharing the wrong one.
I don't know, Ember. We don't have any, brisk iced tea, do we?
I bought brisk iced tea. I went to the store. It's in the car.
Oh.
What do you mean? What do you think I was out all day? I cannot believe this. I cannot believe this. This happens all the time where you always assume I'm not going to do what you want.
No, but I didn't remember asking for brisk. I remember
You said I need some ginger ale, and while I was there, I got the brisk. No, you didn't ask me for the brisk. But that's my job, is to read your mind. That's my whole point of me being here. Otherwise, you wouldn't keep me around if I wasn't always getting you things you need.
You can read my mind?
Of course I can!
That's freaky.
How can I still be married to you? You'd end up being married to some other hot girl if I couldn't read your mind. The whole reason you're with me is because I can read your mind.
Wait, married to a hot girl? What? There's an option?
No, there's not! I'm getting your friends.
I have an option?
No, you don't. I'm going to throw things at you at this point.
I get options after 18 years? Nobody told me. What's that?
You do not have an option.
I have no options.
No!
Okay.
Oh, darn it.
There is a shoe that just came flying at me. Objection! Yeah, brisk will help. Question is, can I connect the brisk iced tea to the ginger ale? Should I even do that? Probably not. Brisk iced tea has caffeine. I've had a very long day, people. I had to clean the house early in the morning. I had to work with the computer company monitoring people. That was a very long, arduous thing. I had to work with YouTube this morning, because now they're involved with the DDoSing case. Wait, does this gum have aspartame in it again or no?
What?
What?
What is that?
I don't remember opening the other. Did you have one of my other?
What are you saying?
I don't remember opening this other thing of gum.
I opened it.
Oh.
I ran out of mine.
Oh, okay. You've been eating my gum now, okay. Okay, it was my pack, but then you had some. That's fine. I've never done this case, people, so I don't know.
I don't understand. You
what?
Had a tiny bit of sleep.
I had a tiny bit of sleep. Yeah, I slept from noon until 4 o'clock.
Well, I don't know what you want. I didn't know you slept at noon. I thought you were asleep at 10 o'clock.
I need to get a mug so I can have the breath. Because I have ginger ale in my other mug.
You want me to get you a mug? Is that what you want?
Is that an option?
Oh my gosh. Fine.
Thank you, QP.
I don't have a choice. If you went up to get the mug, you would end up tripping over the table and smashing your head on the corner and then dying.
Wait, what? What are you planning to do to me? All because I said I get to marry a hot girl? That seems kind of like... intense.
You're supposed to say I'm already married to a hot girl.
I am married to a hot girl. Who? You, right. Yes. Maybe I should try a red Christmas mug then. It doesn't matter to me, just... I've used it before, I think. Sorry, I'm like I said, it's been a long day.
You know, turning the lights on will do makeup.
Why would turning the lights on help?
Because people can see better when there's light on.
People can see better when there's light. Okay.
This could take a while.
There we go, a little ASMR action for you guys.
This is a clean mug. Yeah.
Are you sure there's no brisk left? Besides the one I just got?
I'm pretty sure. This is the new brisk, right?
Yes.
Okay.
There's nothing wrong with the old one.
I didn't even know there was any old ones left.
I don't know. I mean, there's tons of sodas sitting in the house. I don't know what they are.
Okay.
That'll help.
I went straight to Master Tornado's dressing room to say hello.
Hold it!
I slowly turned him into David Hayter, and I didn't mean to do that.
Well, actually, now he's not clenching his teeth anymore, so you're gonna have to find another voice for him. Since he's not going like this.
Yeah, he was clenching his teeth all the time. So I guess now he's David Hayter, I don't know.
I don't even know who that is.
David Hayter is Solid Snake.
Oh.
Colonel.
Yeah, he should be Solid Snake.
Bring! What?
I was doing the Solid Snake thing. Bring!
That's not the Solid Snake thing.
Yes, it is. When Yes, it is. Bring!
It doesn't sound like that.
Yes, it does. That's what the exclamation mark sounds like.
No, that's not what the exclamation sounds like.
Yes, it does. Bring! Oh, yes, it does.
No, just read your line.
It literally sounds like that.
Read your line!
How did Master Tornado appear when you said hello to him? Simon? Mr. Blackwell?
I went with the intention of greeting him, but ultimately, we didn't actually meet.
You didn't even see him? Why not?
Garu escorted me to the dressing room, but we heard the sound of Ragu being performed from within. Thinking the master was rehearsing, we decided to wait in the hall until he was done.
You heard Rakugo being performed in the dressing room?
Yeah, not just me, but the other person as well.
Gairu. Yeah, Gairu, I would say.
In other words, you can confirm that the victim was still alive around 4 p.m.? Correct. I couldn't hear him clearly through the door, but I'm sure it was Master Tornado. I could tell because it was the time soba routine being performed in there.
So that means the victim was killed sometime after that.
Probably. Becky, Bucky went into the dressing room soon after.
Hold it!
Please tell us in detail how Mr. Wet appeared at the time.
We were waiting in the hallway for the master to finish practicing when Bucky appeared and entered the dressing room with his things.
What happened after that?
We heard what sounded like Bucky shouting inside the room. About 10 minutes later, Bucky came out of the dressing room looking rather irate. This is most likely when the murder was committed. The victim was an elderly man. It would have been entirely possible to kill him within the span of 10 minutes.
I'd better come up with some kind of counter-argument, and fast!
Master Tornado's junior disciple apparently then entered the room soon after.
Hold it!
What do you mean by apparently? Didn't you see him go in?
No, I couldn't. I wasn't able to see the dressing room from where I was standing at the time. But,
Geiru?
Geiru, yeah, was right in front of it. So I'm sure she saw it all.
Wait, I thought Geiru was a guy.
Gay? I think it would be Geiru. 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 You could say Geiru. It doesn't matter.
I thought Geiru was a guy. Now it's she.
I have no
idea. Oh, it's the clown girl, probably. I don't know.
I see. So, and why do you suppose Uendo went to the dressing room anyway?
He had finished his routine, so he was making a courtesy call. A disciple is to pay their master respect right before and after each performance.
And all disciples are expected to do this?
Right. Yes, it's common courtesy among Ragu artists.
I see. Could you tell us what happened after Uendo went into the dressing room, Mr. Blackwell?
Certainly.
Thank you.
That's when Uendo discovered Master Tornado's body.
Hold it!
Hold it! And how did Uendo act at the time?
After Uendo had been in the dressing room the 2 or 3 minutes, we heard a scream from inside the room, and they came flying out.
Did you hear any signs of a struggle at that time?
No, just Uendo's woeful scream.
I see.
Well done, Prosecutor. Your testimony has given us quite a glimpse into the sequence of events.
Thank you, Prosecutor Blackwell. And now, please allow me to summarize your testimony. While Prosecutor Blackwell and Geiru were in the hallway waiting for Master Tornado, the accused came along and entered the dressing room with some items in tow. He was heard shouting for a time inside the dressing room, and about 10 minutes later he came out of the room seeming rather angry. A short time after the accused had come and gone, Uendo went into the room. A few minutes later, after having discovered the victim's body, Uendo gave a scream and came running into the hallway from within. Prosecutor Blackwell and Geiru then ran into the room and saw the body for themselves. From the circumstances, it's quite clear that the accused murdered the victim.
This is crucial testimony indeed.
Is it now? Maybe it is.
Okay.
Defense. An eyewitness has given conclusive testimony. Why not let it all go now and allow the victim his last rites?
Not on your life, sad Maddie. If Uendo went into the dressing room too and was the first to discover the body, then who's to say if he didn't commit the crime?
Uendo was in the dressing room for a mere 2, perhaps 3 minutes. He could not have possibly committed the murder in that time, nor without making any noise.
Oh, Simon, why did you have to give that awful testimony? Prosecutor Blackwell!
Why?
Can't you give me something a little better to work with here?
Isn't it up to you to get the questions right?
Sorry.
What?
Isn't it up to you to ask the right questions? I'm certainly willing to tell you all that I know. So if you truly are capable as you claim, then draw out what you need yourself.
It's no time for your twisted games, Prosecutor Blackwell. Just admit you don't remember it that well, okay?
Silence. Jibber jabber jibber jabber.
Okay.
Prosecutor Blackwell, Watching you collude with a defense like this, I see that you are no prosecutor. Begone, witness! You shall haunt this sacred hall no more! Huh. How dare you treat me like some evil spirit to be exorcised. I'll remember this, you blackguard.
Oh, wow, I've been exorcised.
Whoops. Don't worry, Prosecutor Blackwell. I've got this.
Do you?
Would I have my way, he would not be the only one here to step down. You half-boiled putrid egg yolk.
Ah! I object to the notion that I'm a gooey, smelly mess.
Prosecutor Blackwell's testimony was like the lowly opening act of a ragu show. He may hold the title of prosecutor, but this time he stood on the side of the defense. To restore balance to this trial, I would like to present an actual witness for the prosecution.
And who is this witness?
The person who was with the prosecutor Blackwell when the body was discovered. She is another entertainer of the Tornado School. Miss, Geru Tornado.
It's Meme Girl.
Meme Girl! Ah!
Please state your name and occupation, witness.
Hello, everyone! I'm here to represent the Tornado School of a Twisty Twist Twist! Oh my. And balloon! There you have it! A stunning balloon hat! It's me, the balloon artist you all know and love, Geru Tornado! Just call me Geru, sweetie! 1, 2, balloon!
Yes.
Great.
What a way to capture your audience with those very nice balloons. I dare say I can't take my eyes off your balloons.
Please tell me you're talking about the hat, Your Honor!
I'm sorry, what?
Oh, Mr. Judgy, I'm so glad you like my performance. Would you consider joining my fan club? Pretty please?
Oh, absolutely. I love balloons.
You have a wife, sir! And please, save your fanboying for after the trial, Your Honor! Anyway, Geru? Is it?
Okay, next.
Geru? Whatever your name is?
Balloon Girl.
Balloon Woman! Clown Girl!
Right then.
I can't help but notice you seem awfully cheerful for having just lost your master, ma'am. Miss? Of course, I'm sad, but Shishu would scold me if I didn't put on a big smile. Never show sadness. Smile, smile, smile with a twisty twist, twist. And balloon! There you have it! One gorgeous cake! I see. I guess an entertainer's gotta do what an entertainer's gotta do, I guess. Her balloon art's worse than a Rorschach test. I saw several monster head. Ah! Geru, you're obviously a balloon artist, are you not? Do you make things with balloons? Answer the question! How do you come to be a member of the Rakugo school then, since you're dressed as a clown? Well, my late father, that is, was a Rakugo artist, you see? So I joined the Tornado school to be just like my daddy someday. I see. My father and I owe so much to Shisho, our master, but that buggy wet. Oh, how could he? I want to see him pay for what he has done as quickly as possible.
Your distress is entirely understandable, and my condolences for your loss.
And not only that, but he... You have more to say about Mr. Wet, ma'am? Clown ma'am? Every time he comes to deliver soba to us, he yells at me. He always tells me to get away. Is there any reason why he would say such a thing to you? Maybe because of your weird outfit and your clown nose? He says the smell of my perfume will get into his soba and ruin it. Like, how could he say that? This is a great scent.
You're very rude of him. I don't blame you for being upset.
Actually, if stuff did get into his food, then it could poison people if the perfume was in there.
Yeah.
Excuse me, Your Honor, but please don't let Garu's balloons bias your judgment. Mr. Wet hasn't been proven guilty yet, remember?
It will be interesting to see how long that fire of yours will last, Defense. Now then, please share the truth with this court about your balloons. I mean...
Yes, the testimony, please, if you don't mind. I have my eye on you.
Wow, Judge. Wow!
It's not a crime to look!
Yes, it is, Judge!
She's making it so obvious, though.
Balloons. 56.
Oh my gosh.
20. Before the murder.
Before the murder.
From 4 p.m. to a little after 4:20 p.m. when Shisho's body was found, Simon and I were standing in the hallway in front of the dressing room. Before Uendo discovered the body, the only person who had gone in there was Bucky. Come to think of it, a little while before Bucky showed up, Jugamu was barking like mad.
Prosecutor Blackwell, do you have any objections to this witness's testimony?
Oh, I'm still here. No. Tuh. Make your bloody mind up, sad monk. First you exorcise me, now this.
You need only do as you're instructed by this humble servant of the Holy Mother. As there are no objections, Your Honor, let us move on to the salvation of the victim's soul.
Hold it! Hey! I'm the defense attorney here, Prosecutor Sadmati, and I might just have an objection or two once I actually cross-examine the witness! So what are you asking Prosecutor Blackwell for? I'm the one you should be checking with!
There is a passage in the sacred scriptures of my religion.
From Corneria?
That's right. It involves a little fox in an airplane. To stir the wind is beyond the power of a spring chick. In other words, the inexperienced are useless. With that in mind, it seemed more judicious to consult Prosecutor Blackwell.
Ha! He doesn't even see you as an adversary, Sykes Dono.
Well, I won't let either of you two insult me! I'll show you I'm no inexperienced spring chick with egg yolk, jacket. Your Honor, I am ready to cross-examine the witness.
Yes, what? I hope you can make the prosecutor see you as a worthy adversary, Miss Sykes. Allow the cross-examination of Balloonga. You'd better strike while the iron's hot.
Cross-examination. Before the murder was discovered. From 4 p.m. to a little after 4:20 p.m. when Shisho's body was found. Oh! So, the murder must have happened sometime in those 20 minutes. Is that correct, Balloon Girl? But 20 minutes isn't a lot of time, is it? Answer the question! I don't know. I mean, what do you want me to say? That's what happened, you know. Isn't that right, Simon?
Oh, yes. She and I were both, can confirm that the master was still alive around 4 p.m.
Oh, yeah, you can, can't you? See?
She's awfully suspicious.
Simon and I were standing in the hallway in front of the dressing room.
Hold it.
It's almost like she was trying to have an airtight alibi.
The fact that the two of you were there in front of the dressing room means you were able to see everyone who went in and out. Is that correct? Of course! Oh, are you insinuating that I was daydreaming or sleeping while standing up or something? No, of course not. I saw everything, I tell you. Fine. So you say anyway, but did you really? Before Uendo discovered the body, the only person who had gone in there was... Only the defendant and Uendo entered around the time of the murder, is that correct? That's right. That's why it must have been Bucky who killed poor Shishu. Let's take a deep breath, okay, Geru? So, not a single other person set foot in the dressing room during that time. I already told you over and over, didn't I? There was nobody else.
I must apologize on the lawyer's behalf. Even her memory is that of a spring chick's. Please overlook her transgression as best you can.
Oh, I see. Poor thing. Hang in there, sweetie. Hey, who are you calling a bird brain, buddy?
If the shoe fits, wear it.
Come to think of it, a little while before Bucky showed up, Jugamu was barking like mad.
Hold it!
Jugamu, who's that? Is that another person? That's my doggy. I keep him at the theater. Let's see. With a twisty twist twist. Ta-da! And balloon! There you have it. My cute little Jugamu. He's kind of creepy looking, to be honest. Aw, but he's a really good boy. And why was Jugamu barking, ma'am? A clown ma'am? Do you think it's because he saw someone suspicious? Or... If so, then we'd have a new suspect in this case. Now, why was he barking again? Oh, I remember, because it was time for me to feed him. So I went into the yard and gave him some food. Couldn't somebody have slipped into the dressing room while you were doing that? Nope. The door out in the yard was wide open. I would have seen if anyone went into the dressing room, of course. Why would she wear her clown outfit in court? Even people who are clowns in real life, they wear regular clothes off their off days.
It wasn't her off day. She was taken to court, like, during...
Prosecutor Blackwell, come down to the stage for a second. Please, sir.
What? How many times must I do this?
You saw that Gerber was talking about, correct? So why didn't you mention it before?
Huh. I can't be expected to remember every minute detail.
Well, remember them now! Please, Mr. Blackwell! Did Geru go out into the yard, sir?
No, she's not wearing her uniform there.
Yeah, she's wearing a weird clown outfit now, but she wasn't wearing it then. So she didn't wear it on the job, but she's wearing it randomly in court.
She has a cute puppy.
Yes, I remember now that she went to feed that dog. And I saw her looking towards the dressing room quite frequently as well.
Yeah, why was she looking at the dressing room? Okay, Mr. Blackwell. Do you recall anything else, sir?
It looked as though she was feeding the dog a great quantity of dumplings or something. The dog couldn't finish them all, so we buried the rest in the corner of the yard. That's about all I can remember.
Simon's statement has been updated in the court record.
Wow, that's not a lot of evidence either.
We just have some measly pieces of paper.
Yeah.
It looks like Geru was telling the truth. I wish her name was easier to say. Your Honor, I would like Geru's last statement added to her testimony, please, sir.
As you wish, defense.
Your Majesty, whatever your name is.
Well, that's someone else.
Your Honor! I was in the yard.
but the door was wide open, so I could keep watch on the dressing room.
Why were you keeping watch on the dressing room, anyway? So, you know what that means, right, Garu? You weren't in the hallway the entire time after all, were you?
Well, okay. So I did go out in the yard, but it was just for a second. And the yard door was wide open, so I could still see the dressing room the whole time.
The door was open, just you could still see the dressing room. Prosecutor Blackwell, I need you on the stand again, please. Mr. Blackwell!
What am I, your lady-in-waiting?
Do you remember anything about the time that Garu was in the yard, do you?
Simply that dog buried the food he couldn't finish in the corner of the yard.
That's weird.
That's about all I can remember.
Why would he bury it in the dirt, sir?
Because he's a dog.
Thank you, Simon. I didn't really need to hear about that dog again, though.
When I finished feeding Jugamoo, I returned to the hallway. And then I saw Bucky go into the dressing room, no question about it.
Okay, so around the time of the murder, Garu and Simon were hanging out just outside the dressing room. Guess I'm going to have to find a flaw in there somehow, if I can get anywhere. Let's see. Sherry added another statement to the court record.
Alright.
So maybe on the statement that was added, a lot of times an ace attorney, I feel like the statement that's added, something could be there. So they talked about her being out there with her dog.
We're just gonna rain again?
Alright, why don't we look? She said she could see the dressing room from where she was. So, why don't we see what's in the court record? How do we get... It's in the yard. Okay. Darn it, I went too far. I went too far. Alright, so, blah, blah, blah. I was in the yard, but the door was wide open. I could keep watch over the dressing room, okay? So...
Why is it important she's watching the dressing room?
I don't know. That's a weird part, too.
That's kind of suspicious.
Alright, so this is the only picture we have of the backyard where she was. So, this is the... Okay, so we see the dressing room is there. The yard is over there. But look at the door. If she was looking into the door, it would go right into a wall. It wouldn't actually go into the dressing room door. She wouldn't be able to see anything.
So what is that, diagram?
Yeah, that's a diagram. Backstage diagram. I'm going to present it. Is that okay?
Sure, whatever. It's your show.
It's not really my show. We're doing it together. So... You were able to keep an eye on the dressing room while you were out in the yard. Is that correct, miss? Is that correct?
That's right. The door out in the yard was wide open.
I don't think so. Sorry, but that makes zero sense, Garu. Take a look at this diagram of the backstage area. There was a clear contradiction between the diagram and the witness's testimony.
Oh, what? I'm sorry, I was paying attention to other things.
What kind... You know what? I don't want to know, Judge.
I'm afraid I don't understand, Miss Sykes. Please point to what contradicts the witness's testimony.
Well, I don't really understand where she was. Where was she out here?
If she's feeding her dog, the only thing she can see is the hallway.
So this is where she is, then.
Yeah, so she can just see in the hallway.
So she would just see this. She wouldn't see that.
The dressing room is on the other side.
So what contradicts this? So this contradicts it.
I don't know. Something about the picture.
I think we're going to present this.
Whatever you want to do.
I don't know. That seems to be where she said she would be looking. I see. So Garu was in the yard near the doghouse. Prosecutor Blackwell even saw her there.
And while she was out there, the door to the yard had been left open.
I see, yes. Pretty good scribbles.
Yes. Yes, that's right, Your Honor. And if the door to the yard was wide open, as Geru said, it would have blocked her view, making it impossible for her to see the dressing room! What? No way!
But even if there... even if there was admittedly a few moments Geru was not watching, how much would that really affect this case?
It would greatly affect this case, Prosecutor. From the spot Prosecutor Blackwell stood, he couldn't see the dressing room door either. Anyone could have entered the dressing room during that time without being seen. Eek! Geru, why did you try to hide the fact that you weren't watching the dressing room? What?
Hide the fact. You speak as though you think she had something to do with the murder. Rather than deliberate deception, it was more likely a simple oversight. Right, witness?
Well, I was so shocked by what happened. I was just confused, that's all.
Even though she was trying to keep up a brave front as an entertainer, the truth is that she was being torn apart by grief. For her mind to be in turmoil is hardly unexpected.
Yes, it must be very difficult indeed.
To a disciple, one's master is akin to a real parent. Surely her shock is immense. The way this lawyer tries to pin the blame on this poor soul at the first opportunity. All I can say is, the defense attorneys are heartless creatures indeed.
But I wasn't... That wasn't what I was trying to do at all!
It is beyond your comprehension, defense. Your unskilled argument is scarring this witness even further. And if we ask the people of this courtroom, I'm sure they would agree.
Stop battering the witness, Athena. What? The gallery doesn't get a say in this!
Are you afraid to find out what they think? Ill of you, or perhaps that you are in the wrong? Listen to them now, and... Listen to him now with that keen sense of hearing you're so proud of.
He's right. That was really harsh. She didn't have to go that far. I kind of feel sorry for the witness, and why is this lawyer's outfit so yellow?
No! I wasn't trying... I was trying to find the truth! Why is the whole gallery siding with Prosecutor Sadmati?
The people understand. They know what is right and what is wrong.
That lawyer's still in training, isn't she? Why is she all by herself?
I hear the voices of the gallery. I can hear the voices of their hearts! It's so intense. I feel so alone up here, fighting all by myself.
Are you afraid, child? It is ludicrous to come to trial with such paltry preparation of the soul. I command you to leave this courtroom at once.
But I can't give up. I have to keep pressing on. As long as there was a moment when no one was watching the dressing room door, the defendant can't be convicted solely on Prosecutor Blackwell and Guru's testimonies.
Huh. Even now you would continue to resist? You are childish and defeat as well, I see.
I'm not out for the count yet, Buster. I'm just getting started.
Despite your posturing, it is not true that your resolve could crumble at any moment. With but little push, you would surely succumb to despair.
He likes his butterfly.
A little push such as with a piece of conclusive evidence.
Conclusive evidence, huh?
That is correct. We found a critical piece of evidence at the scene of the crime. The victim's dying message, which clearly implicates the accused, Bucky Wheat. Look at these Japanese playing cards, known as...
Karuta?
Karuta. Lined up on the table. These special English versions of the cards spell out the message. That message is wheat number 4.
Oh, wow. Wheat number 4? You mean wet noodle number 4? Or wheat noodle number 4?
Yes. Wet noodle number 4, as the fourth head chef of wet soba is also known. This message points to none other than the accused Bucky Wheat. Wet.
Ah, no!
That makes perfect sense, doesn't it? Balloon Girl's innocent.
Wow, great job, Mr. Prosecutor. No, this is really, really bad. What do I do now?
Crime scene report updated in the court record. Wet noodle was spelled out.
Would you still carry on your futile fight in the face of this irrefutable evidence?
You can say whatever you want,
It is cruel to give the accused false hope. You will only compound his suffering. Wise people of the courtroom, do you not agree?
It doesn't matter what they think. They're not even... He's right. It's cruel to make him suffer when there's conclusive evidence. What an incompetent noob. I feel bad for the victim and the defendant.
What? But I'm trying to prove Mr. Wett's innocence here.
I know you can hear them, defense. Their voices implore you to save the accused's soul. In fact, you should save because there's a thunderstorm.
But I'm just getting started, prosecutor. I don't want to save the case.
I have a bad feeling about this.
I think it's going to be fine. I can't imagine the power going out now.
You don't say it.
I mean, I can't imagine anything, quote, bad happening now.
It is time for you to let go and move on, you inexperienced lawyer. You lack the competence with which to accomplish anything meaningful here.
Is he right? Is this too much for me to handle on my own?
What good is she doing for anyone? She should just quit now.
We love Balloon Girl.
Yeah, we like balloons.
Ah!
How? Now, defense, leave everything to this humble servant of the Holy Mother.
Silence.
Oh. He's trying to use your keen sense of hearing against you to manipulate the trial, Athena. What a cheap trick for a supposedly holy man.
You have the feather in your mouth again, Simon! Simon!
And you, fop doodles in the gallery, can't man watch a trial in peace? This inexperienced amateur is about to turn the trial around.
Does the prosecutor really think she can turn things around?
The mood in this courtroom is starting to change.
Prosecutor Blackwell, what are you doing at the defense's bench? This is unprecedented.
I grew bored of watching from the gallery. Besides, if I were to leave this trial to this spring chick, and lose my favorite soba shop in the process, I'll be quite cross.
You voluntarily stand on the side of impurity and sin. Truly, what a fool you are.
To think you were so easily manipulated by his parlor tricks. Whether it happened to qualified and capable Athena.
I just let my guard down a little bit, Simon. It won't happen again.
Then gird your loins and steel yourself for battle.
I'm not girding up anything with this skirt on! But I am ready to get serious!
It seems there is now yet another soul I must cast down into Hades.
I was in prison for a long time, kid. The hell sounds no worse than a cell, to be honest.
But the fires of Hades will not be at the end of your suffering. For the sin you have committed, you shall surely be reborn as a panda in your next life.
Ooh, a panda.
A white and black reverse panda, that is. And you shall be put in a zoo to be exposed to the public for ridicule.
Oh my gosh! A threat like that won't work on Prosecutor Blackwell at all.
After all, he's already used to looking like a panda in this life.
Huh, who you calling a panda?
Oh, sorry!
I see that you're both prepared to face the fires of damnation. Well, thank you so much, Clown, for your service. You may step down, Balloon Girl.
Okie dokie! Bye-bye, Balloon!
Oh, I was hoping to see more of a Trix.
Does everything have to be about balloons with her?
Now, that big Balloon Girl is gone. I have a witness prepared to testify about the cards.
And who is this witness this time?
The first to discover the body, and someone who witnessed a crime scene firsthand. Mr. Uendo. The time has come for that ponytailed pair over there to finally let it all go and move on.
Very well, let's bring in this witness then.
Soba shop guy.
Witness, please state your name and occupation.
Looks like he's Uendo Tornado, the new one. He's taking the old guy's name.
I guess I could give him a normal speaking voice. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like this guy killed him.
I think it was Clown Girl.
So he's a storyteller, just like the old guy. He's a young storyteller. I guess you could do like a bard singing. I don't know. I have no idea how to do his voice. I guess you just do it normally.
I don't know. I'll try to speak normal, I guess.
Alright.
I am Ragu Storyteller Uendo Tornado. Even if my performance isn't worth watching, I certainly watch my words. I wouldn't want to say anything thoughtless and get arrested.
After all, that'd be a Raku no-no!
Okay, he is an anime character.
Thank you, everybody. Good night!
Hold it! You can't leave yet! You've only just introduced yourself, Uendo!
Oh, my! Are you a fan of mine, miss? Would you like my autograph? One moment, please.
No, that's... Ow! What do you think you're doing, sir?
No need to stand on ceremony. My fan deserves a fan, after all.
A fan for a fan! Nice one! Oh, why isn't... If it isn't Simon... How are you on this fine day, sir?
Quite a dilly for a pickle we've found ourselves in, wouldn't you say?
Don't believe I've ever seen you talk quite so much, Uendo.
Never performed at a place like this, you know. I got butterflies here, and can't you see?
Why do I always get the weird ones?
Pardon me, witness. As much as I enjoy your banter, I believe we had better return to the case at hand.
But you let Balloon Girl talk as much as she wanted.
She was playing with big balloons.
I suppose you're right. In that case...
I was promoted to,
Futatsume.
I was promoted to Futatsume yesterday and received the stage name Uendo. The show is our way of celebrating my new name in middle rank standing hee!
And that happened.
Ha!
I never dreamed of something like that would happen, not in a million years. And just as I thought my chance to start repaying my debt to Shishu, too.
Yeah, plus, I'm worried about, Garu.
Oh.
The way she clung on to the poor thing, I told her to keep a stiff upper lip. Stiff like rigor mortis.
Wow.
Keep telling those lame jokes and Shishiro will come scold you from the grave.
Okay, it's hard for me to read what kind of person this is.
I wouldn't mind getting yelled at, you know, if it meant seeing him again.
Uendo, please, as charming as your various characters are, oh, he's doing different characters. Like, he's like the genie from Aladdin, where he's like posing as different types of voices within the same person.
Right.
This is not a Rakugo stage. Oh, because Rakugo is where you do different voices. So when he was smoking, he had like a different voice where he was serious. Whatever.
Let us hear your testimony now, witness. Tell the court about the evidence left at the scene, the proof of the accused's guilt.
Witness testimony. She shows dying message.
Okay, one sec.
Wow, so how he was like, oh yeah, I guess I'll be getting some, I guess I'll be getting a promotion. And then it's like, I'm so excited about it! Yes. And that was what happened. It's like, it's always like doing different weird personalities. Well, this will be fun for you okay. When you're half asleep.
Yeah. Dying message.
Shishio's dying message.
I noticed Shishio's dying message right away. The stiff cards were right there next to the stiff, you see?
Wow.
Hey now! Enough with the silly puns already! Hee-hee! Anyway, I got the meaning right away. I knew it must have been talking about Bucky.
That was the master's final message, left as he was drowning in soba broth. It was so like Shishio not to write Bucky's name outright. Plain and simple wasn't his style.
Okay.
Well, that was certainly a more entertaining testimony than we usually have, although I missed the monkey. The variety of characters performed by the witness was absolutely splendid.
He shouldn't be performing any characters in the first place here, Your Honor. And Uendo, the murder weapon hasn't been determined yet. So how can you say the victim was drowned in soba broth?
It's obvious. All you have to do is look at the crime scene. He was found with his face shoved in a bowl.
It's only natural to assume he was drowned in the broth for noodles.
Except we're not here to assume things, Uendo, so please stick to the facts. Thank you.
My, it's so like Soma Chef to kill someone this way, wouldn't you say?
Wow.
And with the message he left behind, it's clear, Bucky, we did it!
Setting aside the issue of murder weapon for now, the dying message certainly does seem to be irrefutable evidence.
Someone else could have moved the cards.
Indeed, it proves the absolute guilt of the accused.
Even I've got to admit, I can't see how that message could mean anything else.
Bucky used the soba for the deed, all to get back at the soba shop deed.
I always, like, picture, when I was seeing him going, like, smoking, I was thinking of him as, like, a private eye, I don't know. But, yeah, I guess your thing is better.
I think he's supposed to be a woman. I don't know.
Oh, okay. This testimony makes Mr. Wet look super guilty. I have to do something!
Huh. That's his conclusive evidence? What a farce.
What do you mean, Simon?
What's this? I thought you said you weren't planning on asking me for help.
I did, and I won't. Thank you very much.
Huh.
Simon must have found an inconsistency in the testimony. I'd better listen carefully and try to see what he found. I forgot if we pressed everything or not.
No, you're doing your cross-examination now.
Oh, wow, that was so much intro for that.
Dying message, yep.
I noticed Shishio's dying message right away.
Yeah, if it's hard for you, you don't have to do all of it. I can just say hold it. Wait, oh, I forgot to press it.
Press his first statement.
Okay. This is right away, okay. Hold it! Uendo, when you saw the cards on the table, what made you think they were Master Tornado's dying message?
Well, it was a coded message right there next to the body. I'm sure anybody would have thought that they were there to name his killer. I love murder mysteries, and often watch them on television.
Oh, I see.
I saw a similar scene during a murder mystery marathon last week. That's what made me think this must be a dying message.
I mean, it looks like he left the dying message now.
Yeah, exactly. Like, he saw it last week, so then he thought of it, and then he did it himself!
I don't know.
The stiff cards were right there, next to the stiff, you see.
Hold it! Uendo, the cards were on the table. Your master's body was slumped over. Is that correct? You must have been surprisingly calm to notice them at the time.
As I said, the stiff cards were right there next to the stiff, so they were hard to miss.
Who would it have been more natural? But wouldn't it have been more natural to notice the victim rather than the cards?
The message caught my eye because the stiff cards were right there next to the stiff.
Why does he keep calling the old man a stiff? That's kind of creepy.
Yeah, I thought he took his name. I thought he was like, you should have said to my master's body or something. Why would he call him the stiff?
Yeah.
It's disturbing.
Yeah, but the fact hardly seems significant enough to make a person take note of them.
Stiff cards next to the stiff.
You're creepy, dude! So basically, there was no real reason for them to catch their eye. There was no real reason for them to catch your eye, was there?
Hey now, enough with the silly puns already! Are you gonna press me?
Oh,
still...
yeah.
Hold it!
Sorry.
You haven't gone through all the statements yet.
That's right. I need you to give your testimony, not perform a scene, please. Please remember we're on the witness stand, not the stage.
But look at these wonderful people in the audience! It's only natural for an entertainer to want them to have some fun! I guess we can't let a few jokes slide, right?
Yes, inevitable bleeding of your walk into other areas of your life. I know how that is. I find myself being unwittingly judgmental in my personal life, too.
Right. That's exactly what I'm talking about.
Oh, my God.
Well done, Your Honor. Guess you can't judge a judge by his cover.
Oh, yes. Advise the defense not to be so critical of the witness.
What? Yeah, yes, Your Honor.
Much obliged.
Anyway, I got the meaning right away. I knew it must have been talking about Bucky.
Hold it! The cards do spell out wet, no, four. Which could be interpreted as wet noodle number four, I guess. I suppose you took this to mean Bucky Wet?
There's only one wet noodle around here, and you've seen that giant four on his back. It's the only interpretation that makes sense.
Yeah, from you, because you arranged the cards. Yeah, I guess so, but... But wait a minute!
What is it?
What if there's another wet noodle in the area?
Sorry, what?
Well, what? Did I say something strange?
Bucky is the sole heir to the shop, you idiot. Soon enough... With ludicrous straw grasping.
Hey!
Oh, so enough with the straw grasping.
I'm not trying to straw grasp, Simon. How was I supposed to know?
Just listen to the testimony again and find a glaring inconsistency.
Fine!
That was the master's final message left as he was drowning in soba broth.
Hold it! How could he even make the message while he was drowning? So the victim lined up the cards in his final moments while his head was stuck in the bowl? He didn't even use his hands to get himself out of the bowl so that he would live. He used his hands to make some cards move?
Stop ad-libbing, dude.
Doesn't make any sense. How can you be so certain that's how it went down?
I know, Shishio. He would never let someone get the last word on him, even in death. With his face in the soba broth and his consciousness fading away, he left a message that pointed toward Bucky as he left this world.
He couldn't even see what the cards looked like if his face was in the broth.
Yeah, that would make sense.
It is the only way it could have happened.
Wait! The only way? Now you're just speculating!
Look, a dying message is something you leave as you're dying, right? I saw a scene like that in the detective show.
Uendo, we have a saying in my country. Silence is more precious than diamonds. Please do not speak any more than is necessary.
But talking is my livelihood, you know. I talk all the time. This and that, truths and untruths. I can't stop myself from talking.
Hopefully, he'll stick to the truths without any of those untruths.
It is so like him not to write Bucky's name outright. Plain and simple wasn't his style.
Hold it!
Hold it. But don't you think it is strange? Could a dying person really leave such a convoluted message?
Even in the throes of death, it was Shishio's nature to throw in a twist somehow. Truly, to consummate entertainer till the very end, don't you think?
Was he really that great of a man, Simon?
It would have been no easy task, to be sure. But who knows? He wasn't an entertainer for 50 years for nothing.
If I ever bite the big one like that, I want to leave a message as good as Shishio's. Hee!
Well, let's hope it never comes to that, okay? Simon, are all Rakugo artists like this?
It's hard to say. It could simply be the eccentricity of an entertainer, or perhaps he's hiding something.
Well, he doesn't have to entertain people in the court of law. And if he is trying to hide something, maybe it'll show up as a contradiction or something.
So we did every single statement. Alright, so... Okay, so which one was he? This guy says he drowned in soba broth at some point. He talked about drowning in broth. Where did he say that? He said he drowned in broth. We could look at the autopsy report and see what happened. It must have been torn. That was the master's final message, loved it. Okay, there. Drowning in broth. Drowning in broth. Okay, so let's actually see what...
The master's final message left as he was drowning in soba broth.
Alright, let's see what this actually says. Time of death. Cause of death, suffocation, nothing was found in his lungs. No water, no broth was found in his lungs.
Mm-hmm. Present.
Objection!
There you go.
There is a contradiction in Uendo's testimony.
And what would you care to explain, Wadimus Sykes?
I would. Your Honor? Certainly, Your Honor. According to the autopsy report, nothing unusual was found in the victim's lungs.
Yes, it does seem that way, doesn't it?
Oh, he's sweating.
If he had drowned in a bowl of soba, then there should have been soba broth in his lungs. But since there wasn't any, it means the victim was suffocated with something other than the soba broth.
What?
This is the contradiction you noticed, isn't it, Simon?
Huh, not bad. Not bad at all.
Haha, I guess I showed you.
But if drowning in the soba broth wasn't the cause of death, then what? Then when was the victim's face thrust into that bowl?
Typhu Tornado's face was thrust into the bowl! Well, it wasn't during the murder, because that would mean he would have drowned. If it was forced into the bowl before the murder, he still would have had some broth in his lungs, probably, by the time he was killed. So I'm going to say after, because he was already clearly killed before his face was in there. I'm going to try it. I don't know if I should save first. I'm just going for it.
Because no stoma broth was discovered in the victim's lungs, Your Honor. His head must have been placed in the bowl after he was killed. And that's when the sober broth must have been spilled onto the karate cards. In other words, the victim could not have lined the cards up as he was drowning.
I see. So it was done after he was already dead. Why would the culprit do such a thing?
To frame the other guy.
I'm afraid I don't know yet.
You boast of psychological expertise, yet you cannot determine such a simple motive. My sides are liable to split at the absurdity.
I've never seen you laugh in my life, sir. What? And I suppose you know why, Mr. Said Manny?
Of course. Desecrating the body in that manner indicates a strong sense of enmity on the part of the perpetrator.
Yes, that does make sense. It certainly paints a clear path of the culprit's intense feelings towards the victim.
Feelings of resentment over the theft of the soba shop's deed, no doubt.
Just great. Now the judge has an even more unfavorable impression of Bucky.
Silence.
You must come on... Must you come undone at every juncture? If the culprit had enough time to set up the master Toshido's body... Do you think they would have honestly failed to notice the dying message?
Good point, Simon. The cards were right in front of his body, after all. Rationally speaking, there's no way the culprit could have missed that. Huh?
Objection.
But that was the accused rational at the time, given the way he stormed out of that room.
Silence.
Never mind that. I have something more important to ask of you, Uendo.
Me?
I saw your cards firsthand, did you not? Would you care to tell us about them in a bit more detail? Those tiny crime scene photos show us precious little of what I wish to know.
Well, those cards are from Shoshio's special soba scenes of Tokyo Past Set! Each card is related to some way to be soba.
Spare me the history lesson. Just tell me these cards looked at the scene and no more.
Well, there was soba broth spilled all over them.
That's not much of a help, I'm afraid. Prosecutor, do you have a photo that shows the cards more clearly?
I do. Please accept this meager offering, Your Honor.
My, what a delightful looking cards.
Well. Tearing Prosecutor Sadmug's conclusive evidence apart should be a breeze with these.
Huh?
Don't tell me you haven't noticed.
Don't be silly. Of course I have. Not noticed anything, but I can't exactly say that now, can I? The spill things are different on them than the spill mark. The spill mark is different than how the spill is on the cards.
Oh, so sweet pea. You're making me kind of feel like I'm on a boat.
Karuta cards are added to the court record.
Ms. Sykes, do you really see a problem with the prosecution's claim about these cards?
Well, go on then.
All right! It's do or die time. All I have to do is study the picture and, these cards... Okay, contain a contradiction, were rearranged, are kind of a riddle. They had to have been rearranged because the spill mark was different. Whoops, court record. I'm just looking. Okay, let's go look at them. Details. Okay, look at this. The pattern of spill. Oh, can you see that the pattern? Do you guys in the chat see that? Like that one on number 10 up there. The 10, the one with the woman eating the broth. It's almost completely covered with broth, but that doesn't match the spill mark underneath it.
And that one over there, like, there's one over there that has only a tiny bit of broth, but it's all the way in the broth. Mm. So that doesn't look normal.
Mm.
That's not correct. They were rearranged, I think.
All right, go for it.
These cards were rearranged.
How can you tell?
Please take a good look at these cards, Your Honor. The answer is right in front of us.
What exactly are we should be looking, Miss Sykes?
The broth stains. Yep, the broth stains, I think. Please focus your attention on the silver broth stains on these cards, Your Honor. The outline of these stains do not match up with a larger stain on the table.
Oh, would you look at that? You're absolutely right. And?
Please recall that the silver broth was spilled and got on the cards after the murder. When the victim's face was planted in the bowl, sir.
Yes, go on.
Yes, by the stains we can clearly see that the culprit deliberately rearranged the cards after that. In other words, this message was altered in order to pin the crime on my client.
What? Then if you put the cards back in their original positions,
we can restore the evidence and see who the cards were really pointing towards.
That's true.
Then, what are we waiting for? Let's do this! All I have to do is rearrange the cards so that all the stains match up. Let's see, where was the W card originally? What?
One sec.
What's the matter?
Okay, rearrange your cards.
Alright, so I'm gonna rearrange this. So this one would be the marking would be here, I think. Perfect! Okay, the H card is next. The H card has white on the bottom and stain on the top. Okay, so white on the bottom, stain on the top would be here. Yes, now the E card. Let's see, where was this E card originally? That has white on the corner and stain in 3/4 of it. So that would be here. A perfect match! Next up is the T card. Okay, this one just has a white on the lower right and then a stain on most of it on the top. Great! That fits in right in there. Now the N card. Let's see, where would the N card fit originally? Over here, where there's just a tiny piece of it. That looks good. Now the O card. Okay, that is mostly stain on the lower right. Oh, lower right. Nice! Almost done now. The last card is 4. Let's see, where was a 4 card originally?
Take that!
So the message, what number 4, was originally supposed to say Owen 4th! And this original message is our clue to identify to the identity of the true culprit!
What? Interesting.
That ignorant look on Prosecutor Sadmug's face is positively priceless. This is absurd!
Oh, so it was the original Owen the 4th. It wasn't wet number 4. Maybe the lawyers drove smarter than we thought.
Hold on! Order in this court, please. Well, I never would have imagined that there was more to these cards than meets the eye.
Haruda cards updated in the court record.
So now that's settled, what does this Owen Forth mean?
Wait, am I...
Who else do you suppose is to provide an explanation? Of course it's you, fool.
But I hadn't even thought of that far yet, Simon.
Change the cards around all you'd like, but if you cannot explain what the message means, then it's as worthless as you are, defense.
No!
Putrid egg yolk. And so the spring chick that fancies itself a graceful swan is brought back down to earth.
I have to do something, but what?
Still your thoughts for a second. There's a perfectly good witness to question over there.
Oh, right! That's a good idea, Simon. Come on, Athena. Get a hold of yourself. Uendo! Does the phrase Owen Forth mean anything to you at all?
No, there's no one named Owen in the Tornado family, or our circle of friends.
There is an Uendo.
Go ahead, ask anybody you'd like.
You can't be serious!
Having rummaged through your empty mind, I see you have, as expected, turned up with nothing.
Silence!
Huh. I'm afraid I have no idea who the devil this Owen Forth is, either. But the fact remains that the cards were rearranged to pin the blame on Wheat. That in itself proves that the defendant isn't the real culprit. Double slam.
Prosecutor Blackbull is right! Besides, the important question here is not who does the message point to, but rather, who rearranged the cards?
Huh. Why didn't you point that out earlier if you already knew?
Sorry. In any case, there were two opportunities for someone to rearrange the cards, Your Honor. The first was when Mr. Wet entered the dressing room, and the second was when Mr. Uendo discovered the body.
Are you accusing me of rearranging the cards?
Maybe.
Me, who came to testify out of the goodness of my heart?
Well, you didn't exactly come running out screaming right away, did you? Even a mere 2 or 3 minutes is more than enough time to set up some devilry. So what exactly were you doing in there, Uendo?
Oh, interesting.
Sip, sip, sip.
Put down your tea and spit out your answer.
Eep! Mr. Prosecutor! What's a guy supposed to do at a time like this?
Silence is more precious than diamonds, witness. Therefore, you need only stay silent. The defense is devious. They're waiting for you to make a slip of the tongue.
Oh, I see. So that is why they're after. Is it? In that case, Your Honor, I've decided not to say another word.
Very good. After all, your right to remain silent is protected by law.
Well, Prosecutor Blackwell, any other brilliant ideas you'd like to share? Simon?
Did you hear that, Sykes Dono? The ragu artist who's afraid to speak, who's ever heard of such a thing?
Yeah, it shows that he's climbing up because he's scared.
Are you trying to taunt him into talking? Such a petty trick will never work.
That is right. I am not going to fall for it.
You just talked.
I'm only asking to hear your story. Besides, it's not your job to tell your tales if there's an audience to listen.
Even so, I have a right to refuse to answer.
The more you keep quiet, the more we want you to talk. That's simply human nature. Isn't that right, people of the gallery?
Oh, he's turning the gallery on him.
Oh, he does that.
Yes,
as a prosecutor.
We want to hear him talk.
Maybe this guy did come.
I think
maybe
so.
For once, Balloon Girl's not responsible.
Yeah.
Even with this wonderful audience in front of you, you still refuse to talk. Even so, then perhaps you chose the wrong line of work, my friend.
Are you saying I should quit because I'm not afraid to speak my mind? I'll have you know. Oh no! Never mind what I just said. It is scary to talk, absolutely terrifying. But no, a ragu artist, I must talk. If I don't, how can I ever show my face on stage again? Your Honor, I am ready to testify.
He did it! He managed to convince Uendo of his power of suggestion technique!
Ha, bully for you, Uendo. That's a real ragu artist should be.
All right then, I'm so confused. If the witness wishes to testify, then by all means, please do.
To be turned by such an obvious ploy. What a man of weak spirit.
Whoopsies.
In the dressing room. All right, here we go.
He must have two different like parts of his outfit so he can turn from one side to the other to show that they're two different characters.
I don't know.
Yeah, I think the character he plays when he's pretending to be a lady is the one where his hair is in front of his face. And then when he pretends to be a guy, he goes the opposite side. It's hard for me to understand that.
I don't know.
After my performance, I went to visit Shishio.
I called him from outside the room, but he didn't reply.
When I entered the dressing room, I saw Shishio slumped over the table motionless. From what I can tell, there do not appear to be any inconsistencies in the testimony.
Of course there aren't any, because I'm not trying to hide anything.
Prosecutor Sadmati's right. I don't see anything inconsistent either, but I did pick up on some faint discord in Uendo's heart.
Huh. Ponder all you would like, defense, but it is pointless. Your Honor, I believe there is no need for further deliberation.
Hold it! I disagree, Your Honor. I detect a discord in the voice of the witness's heart.
Say what now?
That's a clear indication that Uendo is facing some sort of inner turmoil.
Are you saying what I think you're saying, Miss Sykes?
What do you think I'm saying, Your Honor?
I'm confused.
Yes, Your Honor, I am. Reading your mind. The defense would like to conduct a quick therapy session on this witness.
Objection.
Uendo, there is no need for you to submit yourself to this so-called therapy.
It's fine by me. I have nothing to hide. Bring it on.
You fool. I will not listen to the guidance of this humble servant of the Holy Mother. Mother?
If the witness wishes to proceed, I see no problem, Prosecutor.
In one ear, out the other. It seems this performer has no need for your so-called guidance, Prosecutor Sad Monk. Just know this, Uendo, your folly will surely earn you divine retribution.
Thank you, Simon. I'm going to make the most of this opportunity that you have created for me.
Huh. Just keep your wits about you.
I will. Uendo, could you tell us again about what happened in the dressing room, please?
Moon matrix time. Activating matrix.
My robot will be analyzing what you have to say. Because reasons.
Alright.
One sec. So this is moon matrix now?
Yep, moon matrix time.
Moon Matrix.
After my performance, I went to visit Shishio.
How do I go to the next one? Oh, never mind.
I called to him from outside the room. But he didn't reply. When I entered the dressing room, I saw him slumped over the table motionless.
Alright, so this one he's happy.
But he didn't reply. I called for him.
Happy. Happy, 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 happy. sad. But he's not shocked or angry or anything.
I don't know.
He's not surprised that he was... He's not surprised at all?
I guess not.
Well, I think we should try surprised. I would be surprised or angry. Surprised or angry. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. I didn't really notice anything unexpected.
But it isn't always a question of pressure. But it isn't always a question of presence, of an emotional response, but the absence.
You know, you're right, Simon. It's not always the emotions I do see. Sometimes it's a matter of what I don't, but would expect to see. I'd better carefully compare Wendo's statements to his emotions again. After my performance, I went to visit. He's happy. I called to him from outside the room, but he didn't reply. I would think that he would be kind of worried at this point, but he's not. Then, when I entered the room, then I saw him literally dead. So, I'm gonna go with... Oh, darn it! I don't know how to do this. I'm not used to doing this. How do I actually pinpoint an emotion? I don't know how to do this. I would say he should have been surprised when he saw his master dead. The one where he saw him slumped over.
So statement 4?
No, the last one where he saw him stumped over.
Yeah,
that one.
Statement 4.
So I think we should use L. Oh, then you use L.
Like this?
Yeah. I think we should try that because he should have been either that or angry if it doesn't work out. Uendo, I'm noticing something strange with your emotions.
Something stranger with cheesy toe skin, you say?
No! Something strange with your emotions is what I said. How could you have heard some thin stranger with cheesy toe skin from that?
I don't know. Maybe it's me who's got some cheese in my ears.
Did he will the floor to open up and swallow his cushion out of shame for the bad joke? The point I'm trying to make is that I noticed something unexpected in your emotions, sir. Now stop hiding and come out where we can see you!
Bailiff, please bring the witness a few replacement cushions!
He's sitting down? He's supposed to be standing.
So what? This is an unexpected thing you noticed!
Oh my gosh, he's way up now! Come on! His Honor said a few cushions, not a dozen!
Yes, that's right. Now! We've had all a good laugh. Please continue, Miss Sykes.
Who's laughing?
Japanese humor.
Focus, Athena. Don't let yourself get rattled. When you entered the room and saw your master slumped motionless over the table, Uendo, you weren't the least bit shocked, were you? Don't you think that's a little odd?
Is it, though?
The lack of surprise means you were prepared for what you saw. And I think I know why. The reason Uendo wasn't shaken when he saw his master's dead body is because...
He knew about his death.
He had to have known he would be dead. He was zoned out. He has the entertainer's guts. He had to have already known that he was dead. He knew about his master's death. Uendo, I think maybe the reason you weren't shaken was because you already knew you would find your master dead. Ooh.
He knew already. Amazing.
What? What kind of thing is that to say? You got it all wrong. Oh, right. I just remembered something. I thought Shishio was sleeping when I first saw him.
Wow, yeah, right.
This
no, you didn't.
Sus.
You did not. You're saying you thought he was sleeping? Okay, it's plausible, but... What made you think he was asleep, Uendo?
Huh? Well, he had his head on his arms up on the table as if he was taking a nap. Oh, and another thing! There was a note that's... Two!
Note? A note? What note?
He must be talking about this.
Okay.
Resting, do not disturb. It appears to have been written by the victim. Allow me to read it. Resting, do not disturb.
I can already read it over here, prosecutor.
Yes, that's the note I saw. Hee. After reading that, you wouldn't think Shishio was napping.
That is pretty reasonable assumption, yes.
You've got to be kidding me. Typhoo's note added to the court record.
That's right. I saw his note. So that's why I thought he was asleep.
I went to change my testimony to include that statement.
All right. I will run an update then.
Okay, more mood matrix stuff.
After my performance, I went to visit Shisho. I called to him from the outside of the room, but he didn't reply. Alright, now we have an edited version. When I opened the door, I thought he was sleeping, but something seemed off, so I rushed over to him.
Why angry?
I was shocked to find him dead. I couldn't believe my eyes. And that's the last one. So we have to figure out... So you think angry? There was something off, so I rushed over to him. Wouldn't he be surprised? Or something? Why would he be angry? There was something off, so I rushed over to him. I think we should try this, like you said. How do we go... Look, how do I do the unexpected... Oh, here we go. Okay. And then I just press X?
Yep.
He's angry that he was sleeping.
Uendo, I noticed something funny with your emotions again.
Huh? Funny, you say? I guess an entertainer of my caliber can make people laugh even with my emotions.
I didn't mean that kind of funny. Quite the opposite, actually. When you entered the dressing room, I see that you suddenly felt anger. What I want to know is what made you feel angry all of a sudden.
What? Let's see. Oh yeah, now I remember. As I was going in, I whacked my little piggy on something. I was annoyed at my own clumsiness.
Wait, you mean you stubbed your pinky toe?
Just a little bump on my little piggy. No, big deal. It was embarrassing, really.
Sounds more like he's hiding something. Better dig a little deeper. No need to be embarrassed, Uendo, but I'm afraid it's something we do need to look into here.
Stubbed his toe?
I don't really see anything you could have stubbed your toe on in the area around the dressing room door in this picture. But maybe there was something there at the time. Uendo, what exactly did you stub your toe on?
Objection!
You gotta stop rocking him. I'm getting busy, sweetie. What an irrelevant question. You dishonor the soul of the victim with these unnecessary delays.
You tell her, really. Who doesn't stub their toe every once in a while? You really got a few fuss over every small detail like this.
Well, the thing is... Even the most subtle of fluctuations in a person's psyche can clue us in on the truth. That's why it's important to get to the bottom of this question. Plus, if I back down now, who knows what new insult Simon will hurl my way. Is there really no trace left of what Uendo stubbed his toe on by the door? What in the world might have been there then, but is not there now?
No idea.
Oh, look at these drag marks. Looks like something was dragged. I think this TV may have been dragged.
Okay.
I don't know.
The TV could have been moved. The TV is huge. I don't think this could have been moved because this is like a shelf built into the wall. These pillows, he could have stubbed his toe on this. This, like, eating thing. If the table had been dragged over there, he could have stubbed his toe on that. I'm gonna guess the TV, I guess. What does the chat think? Does anyone know on the chat? TV is the chat saying. It was the TV. Alright, we're gonna try the TV, guys. Let's try it.
Take that!
Please take a look at this photo of the crime scene, Your Honor. Oh. Do you see it? This long track that goes from the door all the way across the room.
Yes, now that you mentioned it, I do see traces of something being dragged.
And the drag mark ends there, at the TV, Your Honor. This implies that the TV was originally by the door. I'm convinced that this TV is the object the witness stubbed his toe on. Well, Uendo, how about it?
Yes, you're right! It was the TV!
Okay.
Oh, wow.
He's still going.
Yep. There, the noise level dropped again.
Yes, I stubbed my pinky toe on the television. But what of it? Why is it so important to you?
So the noise went down, but it hasn't completely disappeared yet, which means he's still hiding something. Okay, let's try this tactic instead. Uendo, why was the TV moved there? Do you know?
Shishio must have moved it if he could, it's so he could watch my routine. But what a place to put it, right in the middle of the doorway like that? I didn't want to bump into it again, so I put it back where it belonged.
Performances on stage can be viewed in the dressing room using that TV?
That's right! It's a closed-circuit monitor that shows the stage!
Crime scene report has been updated in the court record. I see. Now what? I can't even find anything else out of place here. And I still haven't gotten the noise level down to zero yet. Simon, I'm still getting noise here, but I don't see anything else fishy.
Huh. This is precisely why amateurs are such a bother.
Sorry.
I'm in no mood to play nursemaid here, but if that's what it takes to save the soba shop. Hey. Hoi, Uendo. There's a curiosity for you. This table Master Tornado has slumped over looks like it was moved. Did you happen to bump into it while you were moving the TV back?
Oh my, yes, you're right! The TV hit the table and Shishio's body moved with a jolt! That's when I first realized that Shishio was dead! Oh, but I was scared. So scared!
I see. Thank you. We're finally getting a more precise picture of how the body was discovered. But I'd wager you need to put the spurs to Uendo's just a trifle longer.
But right! Okay, Simon. I can't keep asking Simon to bail me out like this. It's time for me to regain my footing and really stand on my own as a lawyer. Uendo, what you said just now about discovering your master's death, could you please describe all that again for the court in detail?
All right.
But before you do, let me just plug in the latest information.
All right, Amber, save if you can.
Okay, save. How do I do that?
Go to options. Go to records. Records.
And it won't let me
go to records.
Save. Oh, I
save.
Now I go here?
No, click on the one that says Storyteller save. There's right there.
Wait,
it's
I'm sorry.
Storyteller. You just passed it again. Nope. Yes. Yes. Save. Okay, press back.
Okay, we already saved, right?
Mm-hmm.
5:38 p.m. Why does it say... Oh, 7:05. Okay,
keep. Yeah, go back.
Yeah. Alright. Are we done or no?
No.
Can I keep going? Okay. After the performance, I went to visit Shisho. I called to him from outside the room, but he didn't reply. When I opened the door, I thought he was sleeping. Now new updated info. Tried to enter the dressing room, but I stubbed my toe on the TV. When I put the TV back into its normal spot, I realized that Shisho was dead. Now we have more information. Seeing him slumped over that cluttered table, then he just starts crying. I'm not really seeing any emotions I'd consider out of place. How about you, Simon?
How many times are you gonna come running to me?
No, I was just looking for a second opinion.
Huh. Well, take another good look at the flow of emotions. Don't just look at the simple inconsistencies. Look at the intensity of his emotions, too.
I see. Thank you, Simon.
Okay, so what do you think?
Because right,
remember,
well,
I haven't done this one. So.
Well, I called, we were here. After my performance, I went to visit Shisho, so he's happy. I called to him from outside the room. He's happy. But he didn't reply. He's happy. When I opened the door, I thought he was sleeping. So no emotion. I tried to enter the dressing room, but I stubbed my toe. Anger. I put the TV back to its normal spot. I realized that Shisho was dead. Surprise, sadness. And seeing him slumped over the cluttered table, and it has even... So actually, look at this. He's halfway surprised here, but he's extremely surprised here, even though this is when he found out he was dead. So what could have surprised him even more than death? I'm gonna go with that. I think something is weird with that. We're gonna go present pinpoint.
Got it!
I'll try that. I don't know. That is odd. After the initial shock of finding the victim dead, you reacted with surprise again and even more? What was it that surprised you, Uendo, besides your master's death?
What do you mean?
What's more, you were even more surprised the second time than the first. What could have surprised you more than finding your late master dead?
Search me, you little thingy. Must have made a mistake.
Silence.
Huh, the girl's as sharp as a trout, to be sure. But her ability to hear people's emotions is absolute. Now get to remembering, Uendo. What was it that surprised you?
That was a compliment, right?
Well,
Uh-oh.
Oh, man, now there's a lot of... No! We pushed him too hard. Now he's mentally all over the place. His emotions are completely out of control now.
Out of control? Care to explain how that's relevant?
You know how normally I listen for the hidden emotions in a witness's voice, right, Simon? From there, I look for inconsistencies between their testimony and those emotions. But sometimes a person's feelings can run too high, making it hard to get proper readings.
So that's how your matrix program works. Fascinating.
Ordinarily, it's just one emotion that runs out of control. But it seems like there's nothing ordinary about this time. Wow, all of the emotions are running rampant. After my performance, I went to visit Shisho.
He's
wow,
mad
this
here.
This is insane. Okay. I went to visit Shisho. I called him from the outside of the room, but he didn't reply. When I opened the door, I thought he was sleeping. Surprise. I tried to enter the dressing room, but I stubbed my toe. Extreme anger. I went to put the TV back. Normal spot. I realized that Shisho was dead. Surprise. Seeing him slumped over that cluttered table. Oh, Shisho. So, he's sad now.
Hmm.
saying there's something wrong with the cards. I don't know.
I think there is something going on with the cards. Because, like, it doesn't make any sense. We just did the last thing where it says he was more surprised at the cards than his death. I think we should figure that out. I knew it!
Huh. It's got your knickers on a bunch now.
Uendo has multiple emotions running out of control at the same time. I've never seen anything like this, Simon, ever.
So, how does one bring a situation like this back under control?
I'll have to find the root cause of this tangled mess before I can treat him. If I can identify what's causing this emotional rampage, then I can probe to dive in further using L1. I'll need to point to what I think is the root cause and hit probe again. Though, through this process, I can identify exactly what's causing Uendo so much distress.
Huh, and that will help bring his emotions back under control? In that case, let's get started, shall we?
All right! I can't guarantee success, but it's definitely worth a shot! Time to look for the root cause of Uendo's rampaging emotions. Alright, well, he's angry randomly now for no reason. He's randomly angry. I called to him from the outside of the room. Now he's randomly sad when he wasn't sad before. Then he said he was surprised when last time he wasn't surprised because he thought he was sleeping. I tried to enter the dressing room, but I stubbed my toe. That's accurate because he would be angry. I put on the TV back to a normal spot. I realized that Chisha was dead. That's accurate. Surprise. And this one, I'm sad. Well, I mean, it makes sense he would be sad. But I feel like we can probe. We have to probe stuff. So L1. I think...
Probably sad about what the card said, maybe.
Yeah, okay. Alright. So let's try that. Probe.
Got it!
I get it now. The cards were the root of it all. Don't try to deny it. You can't hide your feelings from me. The dying message that was left on the scene of the crime is what's causing your distress. If the dying message was the cause of all those feelings, then that means the phrase Owen Forth must mean something to you.
Yeah!
Wow. Voice level to zero. Oh my gosh. There! Noise level zero! Finally!
The dying message consists of two words, Owen and Forth. But neither of these two words have anything to do with this witness. This topic warrants no further argument.
Sure, there may not seem to be any direct connection between Uendo and the message. For now... But why don't you wait and decide what's necessary after hearing my theory?
Huh, I trust you've hit upon something, Athena.
Yup! If my theory is right, we can finally solve the case of Uendo and the mysterious Owen Forth.
Huh, we'll go on then.
I can already tell this promises to be interesting. Now, please share your theory with the court, Miss Sykes.
Gladly, Your Honor. There was something puzzling to me about Uendo's out-of-control emotions just now. Namely, that there were three distinct reactions present. I've never seen this before, and I wondered how it could be possible.
Is there a conclusion to this, meandering musing of yours?
Hold your horses! I am getting there, Mr. Sadmad! So... Could a person flip between three distinct emotions of such intensity like a switch? In the end, I conclude that it just wasn't possible.
Huh, so that's it, is it? A bit of unconventional, but I'll grant you that's possible within the realm of psychology.
Within the realm of psychology? I'm afraid you'll have to explain it for the old man up here on the bench.
Sure, Your Honor. My theory is that Uendo... He is a robot. He has supernatural powers. He has multiple personalities. He has multiple personality disorder.
Probably.
He's not a robot, I don't think. He doesn't have supernatural powers, I don't think. I think he has multiple personalities. I'm gonna go with it. What does the chat think?
Multiple personalities is what I would go with.
Okay. With so many distinct personas, it's clear to me that Uendo has dissociative identity disorder. In other words, multiple personality disorder.
What does that even mean?
Your Honor, the defense would treat this trial as a child's jest. Multiple personality disorder? A preposterous proposition indeed. Would you not agree, witness?
How did she know? How did she figure it out?
Oh, wow. Disturbing.
Surprise!
I can't believe it! I did it! I did it, Simon! I've read papers on this before, but to think I'd see a case of it for myself?
Blimey. Raku artists tell stories as different characters, but as different personalities?
Hey, you lawyer girl! You've got a problem with us, huh?
Us? How many of there are in there, dude? No! No problem at all!
Well then, this is all very hard to believe.
The voices.
But now that we've established that the witness has multiple personalities, could each of them please introduce themselves to the court?
Oh my gosh!
Uendo Tornado, I am the Roku storyteller, as you know.
Hello, everyone. Patches, the friendly jester here.
There are names for his different personalities?
Kisigawa. Crustacean.
Courtesan. And is that all of you in there?
Yes, that's all of us.
So, there are three personalities in total. Uendo, Patches, and Kisigawa. Huh?
Kisigawa's the girl, I think.
Kisigawa, yeah, I think so. Well, Simon, what do you think now?
That you're one lucky duck. Just be glad there are dents enough to help you out.
Can't you just be straight up and say I did a great job for a change?
You appear to be quite proud of your self-defense, but all you've done is infringe upon the privacy of the witness.
I couldn't disagree more, prosecutor. Now that we know there are three personalities going on in there, a new way for us to interpret the meaning of certain pieces of evidence has arisen!
A new interpretation.
Oh, now I'm very curious. What is this piece of evidence you're talking about, Miss Sykes?
Knowing what we know about Uendo and his personalities, this now makes perfect sense. Oh my gosh. Well, he has three personalities, but the card said four. I don't know. Let's see. Quiet. This makes perfect sense. Fourth personality. Named Owen.
Wait, clown girl's not responsible?
Oh my gosh. So, could he have killed the guy? One of his personalities killed the guy and he's not aware of it? He's not aware? That's just...
Alright, I'd present cards
then. I guess. I don't really...
Take that! The cards again?
That's right, Your Honor. Recall the original dying message left at the scene. We didn't have a clue as to what Owen Forth could have possibly meant. But now, with this new information about Uendo and all of his personalities he's got going on, isn't it possible that Owen Forth actually means a secret fourth personality of Uendo's, a personality whose name is Owen?
What? Surprise!
Uendo must have kept his dissociative identity disorder from us because he didn't want to be associated in any way with that dying message.
No, that's not why. We kept our disorder a secret for a different reason altogether. We've been playing, taking advantage of our affliction to act out our various characters. In a word, if this word got out, well,
our reputation as an artist would be tarnished, as would the tornado name.
That's why we kept it a secret from everyone except members of the school. But really, there is no fourth personality. It's just the three of us in here.
Uh-huh.
Huh. A plausible enough sounding story. But it doesn't prove that you didn't rearrange the cards, does it? But... I will concede that it's highly likely that the witness rearranged the cards.
Is Prosecutor Sadmati actually agreeing with us?
However, it is not also is it also not possible that the accused killed Master Tornado? And that left that message in order to frame the witness?
Ah!
And upon noticing the cards when he found the victim's body, Uendo rearranged them.
Silence!
A fantastic tale, but a tale nonetheless. No one outside of the school knew about Uendo's multiple personalities. Uendo just finished saying so himself. Ah, that is true, but ultimately a meaningless point. The witness was only in the dressing room for 2 or 3 minutes. That's far too little time to commit murder, wouldn't you say?
Objection! Then who's to say he couldn't have done it before his discovery?
Objection.
Ah, that spring chick memory of yours. Have you already forgotten Prosecutor Blackwell's testimony?
Simon's testimony? All right.
Huh. The girl escorted me to the dressing room. But we heard the sound of Raku being performed from within. Thinking the master was rehearsing, we decided to wait in the hall until he was done. It wasn't a performance he heard people talking to themselves.
Yes.
That's right, until just a few moments before Uendo entered the dressing room. Tornado was confirmed to still be alive.
He could have been dead, and it could have been the other guy talking to himself.
I don't know.
No!
Not only that, but Uendo was on stage until just before he discovered the body. Bulletproof alibi that I've already confirmed with several audience members.
Oh, no!
Also, I heard that the Raku performance was days. That day was a steaming pile of... Well, you get the picture. Yes, I'm afraid so. I really stuck up the stage. I did.
Really?
And yet, I have a perfect alibi. Indeed. Why not land the coup de grace on the defense by describing your alibi, witness? Okie dokie, Smokey.
If he really stunk up the stage, maybe it wasn't him. Maybe he got someone to pretend to be him or something.
I don't know.
I'm so confused.
Well... Obviously, this case is not going to be done today, so we should do more tomorrow.
Uendo's alibi. Should we do start his alibi or no?
I would save.
Okay.
Because it's almost 7:30 already.
Okay. Oh, okay. Oops. Okay.
Records. Save.
No, I do this?
Mm-hmm.
Which one do I do? The storyteller?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, it says 725. Okay, yep.
Yeah, you saved. Okay. It's a good place to continue tomorrow.
Okay.
Back to main menu. I thought we already saved our progress. Okay. Yoink. Okay, so that's kind of, I don't know if it's a long case, but it's not quite over yet. So anyway, guys and gals, that's going to do it for this episode of Turnabout Storyteller, Ace Attorney Apollo Justice Trilogy. We've got some weird stuff going on with this case. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll be concluding this case tomorrow because there's probably an hour left, if not more. Yep. That's how it goes, yeah. Because we have no idea how long the case is left. Nobody tells us. So we're making a decision to stop now because there could be an hour, it could be 40 minutes left, there could be 2 hours left. We don't know.
Yep.
I've never done this before, so I can't really, you know, figure out, like, how long we're going to stream for. Plus, we have another stream starting in a little bit, so that's how we do stuff. Alright, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Just a reminder that 1,000 views is required for the stream series to continue. This episode didn't do very well for whatever reason. We don't know why. We're ending at 620 views, so 1,000 views is needed for tomorrow or the next day. So that's 700, 800, 900, 1,000. That's 400 views by tomorrow or on Saturday. But yeah, good luck, everybody. Rewatching the stream helps. Leave a comment after the stream. Tell us what you thought about it. And see you guys on the brand new series of Freedom Planet, which will be starting up at 7:40. So thanks so much for watching, everybody. And you'll be redirected to Freedom Planet. Just also a reminder that Freedom Planet won't start unless it hit 40 likes. That stream is currently at 24 likes. So I'm going to send that over, and mods, you can push that. And we'll see you guys on the brand new game, Freedom Planet.
Awesome! Can't wait.
Alright, people, thanks so much.
Thanks for watching, everyone.
See you in a bit.
See you on the next stream.